Good morning or afternoon, depending when you're watching this program, Residents of Somerset. It is Friday and it is October 11th, so it is time with the TA. Thank you for joining me for updates on everything Somerset. I'll start and end with the SAFE event, Somerset's annual fall extravaganza, which is already tomorrow. I'm hoping that, you know, we can continue to get the word out, social media platforms. People tend to vote the success of an event with their feet. So the more people we have at this program, this event, the larger we can make it next year. And, you know, I know I mentioned this before, we were not able to accommodate a drone show simply because of the price and the short window we had in order to raise the money for that. But I do think it's a distinct possibility next year. At some point when we do it, it will be the first time we've ever done it. So hopefully that will be next year. Again, at the high school, tomorrow kicks off at 3. We've combined the safety event that takes place annually with a fall-themed event. There will be a hayride. I learned today that Stop and Shop donated 300 sugar pumpkins. So moms and dads, there'll be plenty of pumpkins that your kids will be able to go home with. We have those competitions and those contests for pumpkin painting, for costume, and we have trophies, we have medals. It's just, the day looks amazing. I guess we made a phone call and it came through for us. I don't know how it'll look next year, but it was cold this morning, but it's supposed to be tomorrow, 70, 72 degrees. I get we're towards the evening. So whatever you have in the morning, whatever events you're attending, swing by at the high school, 3 o'clock. We do have the Massachusetts State Police helicopter coming in, and it's just going to be a great event. There's going to be hot chocolate. There's going to be food trucks. There's going to be vendors. And again, seeing how we do it with this will determine how much we are able to expand this next year and years after. So really looking forward to that. I will be there tomorrow early with the entire family volunteering and setting up. So it should be a great time. Moving on from that, I did take a ride this week down to the Valley Road Project. And it's really been transformed in the sense that everything that was in the street there that they had been using for the pipes, for the head walls, it's all in the ground. I saw an excavator that was doing some finishing touches that were kind of on the west side where the stream is daylighted. So it looks like they're just finishing up there, and then they will end up lumen seeding right before winter sets in. So I do expect that project to be wrapping up here within the next week or two. And I know how crazy this is, but we may never be talking about the Valley Road drainage issue ever again. So, you know, a lot of patience, a lot of hard work, a lot of people involved with this. But I think most of the credit goes to the citizens that were down there. With projects like that, you can never be too outspoken. So thank you for all of the residents that have been staying on top of it, that have been keeping this office informed kind of about the process, the procedure, and things that we needed to address. And thank you to all the employees in this building that have stepped up throughout the time that we've been dealing with this now for 3 years to get this done. So very happy that that's almost behind us. I do have an update. I was talking to our Highway Superintendent Chris Simons, and he was giving me an update from PJ Keaton, who we contract through Sursage, our a kind of group company there for our roadworks. And we're talking about the parking lots and we're talking about timetables. 3 of the parking lots are looking to be slated by the end of this month in the first week of November. And that includes Old Town Hall, that includes the Village School, and that includes the Highway Barn itself. So again, we're using ARPA money for that at no cost to the taxpayers. Those 3 parking lots are alone around $500,000. We're obligated to have that ARPA money at least contracted by December 31st of this year. So one of the things I was hoping to do was deal with Town Hall when it comes to the windows and the HVAC and upfitting this building. But that requires design services under Massachusetts procurement law, which does require some additional steps. And it hurts because of the small timeline that I have to allocate those funds. Again, we'll be giving nothing back to Congress. and we'll ensure that the money spent right here in Somerset. My fallback plan, as I mentioned before, is to continue to enhance our road works, whether that's sidewalks, whether that's parking lots, whether that's streets itself, with the remainder of that money that we're obligated to expend. So, but I am looking forward to having that done. As we get closer to it, I'll put out some dates. We'll have some alternate parking for employees and citizens that will be coming in. Most likely citizens will have to use the Wood Street and kind of share the parking lot with COA and make a little bit of a walk. But I do expect that should only be around 3 days of inconvenience. And then once it's over, the parking lot, which is in desperate need of repair, will have been addressed. So very much looking forward to that. The contracts for the library on the HVAC, I know I keep talking about that. I have those split into two, one for this calendar year that involves four of the HVAC units on the library roof, two for the next calendar year, and for the total of six. And I hope to have that one for the four units, because two of them have failed. One of them's, on the way out. I want to have that fixed. I hope to have that on the next agenda for the next Board of Selectmen meeting. I am working on the RFP for the World War II monument. I was hoping to send that out yesterday, but there were some things that I got pulled into that needed attention. I was not able to finish that RFP. Those RFPs, they have to be into the state by a Thursday in order to be posted for the following Wednesday. So I lost a week there, and I apologize to George Andes and others who are kind of watching that with bated breath to see where we are with that. But that will be taking place, that will be done, and that will be coming from, again, ARPA money, so it will not be at a cost of the taxpayers here in Somerset. I have been in another meeting with the Blue Cross Blue Shield with regards to the field and the grant program, where we intend on submitting an application to the CPA committee in order to have a funding source where we can have the same type of field or similar to the field that I've mentioned in the past in Swansea come to Somerset. So we're still moving forward with that. Last week I was at a meeting at the Diamond High School, and I got to see some of the progress there. And I get it, that's in Fall River. What does that have to do with Somerset? But about 10% of that entire school population is drawn from Somerset. To include our own Ben Corville, who received an award for his life-saving measures last week from the Diamond High School. So congratulations, Ben, and thank you for what you've done. I have no doubt you and your entire family is very proud of receiving that award and everything that you do. You're always out there, whether it's upfitting our fire hydrants or saving lives. Where isn't Ben? So Ben, great job out there. Congratulations. But the piece that I wanted to mention in addition to that is that meeting was important, because just as we were dealing with the issues on the middle school construction here, and they were talking about the MSBA giving us additional money, there was additional money that went to the Diamond Project and their new high school. But prior to that money going there, something very similar happened here. When we didn't have the funds because of inflation, because of the inability to get products in that were either locked up or just, a distance away, and all of these costs had started increasing. What the middle school had done here in Somerset, they began cutting things. There were certain hallways, I believe, that were even cut out of the blueprints in order to shrink some of the, in order to lower the costs of constructing the building itself because of the money that we had. So the same thing happened at Diamond, and Diamond, interestingly enough, cut $50 million worth of facility out of that high school. So that allowed them to stay within the money they had allocated, and we pay a portion of that. So when they do, because it's a regional vocation, we have 10% of our population, our student population, 10% of their student population is made up of Somerset students. We pay a formula into how much annually goes into that. And that includes the construction of that building and paying off that loan or bond. So in this particular example, they cut out the $50 million to keep it within a certain range. Well, the MSBA came back and they put money, much like they did here with our middle school, into that high school as well. But you cannot revisit the facility. So you can't take that money and now go back and say, okay, now we are going to keep the same that it was with regards to that hallway or that balcony or that building or that garage, go back to the original footprint. You cannot. You can use that money towards fields and equipment and other things like that, but not the facility itself. So what does that mean for Somerset? What am I trying to get to? A bit of good news on our side, it means that the amount of money we were originally going to pay annually into the cost of that high school, our portion has gone down because now the MSBA has given more additional money to fund the building of the school, which has had a positive effect on what we will owe. So that money has gone down a little bit, and I don't have those figures in front of me. It still has to be approved. And once all of that is approved, I'll let you know. It's a little bit of a savings, but it's worth mentioning. I got to meet a lot of the staff there. I got to see a lot of the things that they're doing in Diamond, and it is very impressive. And the new building is coming along. The renditions are absolutely beautiful, and I'm sure it's nothing that everyone isn't already familiar with. So we're just a couple of weeks away from the election. And, the last couple of days have been interesting at Town Hall. I know there are things that are being posted now on social media. There's information coming out. And there's always this kind of shade for the last several years when it comes to municipal government national elections. And I will say this. You've got a staff down in the clerk's office, and you've got a staff here at Town Hall, and everyone's working very, very hard on everything. And even though the clerk's office kind of works independently as an elected person for these elections, if there's the ability for us to help out on the town hall government side, we certainly do and will. Sometimes a lot of these things, when it comes to elections, right, they can be derogatory posts. Sometimes they can be threatening, and we've dealt with that over the last several days too. So my kind of message to the residents here in Somerset is to kind of reassure and say that, look, there's nothing that everyone in this building is committed to making sure we have fair and safe in elections. And anything I can do to kind of reinforce that notion or ease any concerns, please don't hesitate to call myself or the town clerk or the state. We'll deal with these things as they come up. But one thing we really can't allow, or we don't want to happen, is this to degrade into threats to employees, which is starting to happen. And it's not fair to our employees. The residents of Somerset know the people that work here and how hard they work. And then to have, these kind of these social media platforms come in and threatening those people. It's one thing to point out something that might need to be addressed or might need to be fixed, or say, hey, we can do this better, or maybe this isn't being done right. It's another to take it to an extreme or another level and actually make threats about the safety or lives of people that work in this building and for this community. That will not be tolerated, and we will take every step and every measure we can to ensure that not only are our people safe, that we have a good and proper election, and we can be an example for everyone else. So it's not something I was kind of unsure on whether I wanted to discuss it or not, but it is important. There are times that things become really difficult, and we need to come together as a community and not read in to what might be untrue or allow our imaginations to run away with us. Anything I can do from this office, I will continue to do. And I think I speak for the clerk when I say she's doing everything that she can down there for the same purpose and reason. All right, let me switch over to sports. We have the high school field hockey team beat Durfee 2-0 on Thursday. You had Addie Finlaw and Karis Botello scored the goals. Goalie Sophia Valcourt had 3 saves. And going back to what we started with, please make every effort to come down to the Safe event tomorrow at 3:00. Even if it's early, you don't feel comfortable driving at night. The sun's supposed to set just after 7:00. There's a lot of lighting over there. But even if you just want to check it out, walk around, and then take off, It's going to be a great time. It's going to be a great event. And I'm sure there are going to be things that people will let me know what we can do better for next year. But I'm interested in hearing those too, because we want to have a great event that we can continue to repeat. So, look, thank you very much for spending your time with me on a Friday afternoon. I hope everyone has a safe and wonderful holiday weekend. Town Hall will be closed on Monday. Not people probably weren't getting prepared to line up for us on Monday anyway, but I hope everyone enjoys a safe and wonderful long weekend. I'll see you next week. Thank you.